is home to over 100 mammals, and mammals are covered in hair and feed their young milk via mammary glands. Some mammals, like the elk, are extirpated from Maryland. Extirpation means that they're locally gone, and extinct means they're gone forever. So elk can still be found in other parts of the United States, similar to gray wolves and American marten, as well as the snowshoe hare. Unfortunately, the eastern mountain lion species is considered to be extinct in the United States. To identify mammals, you should pay attention to some key features. Much like with other species, looking at the size and the shape of the animal, looking at their color patterns, looking at their overall behavior and how they're acting in the environment, and looking at the habitat that you find them within will all help you with identification. Similar to other species, it's best to learn groups or families of animals to assist with identification and to understand certain characters that they have. Let's start off in the order Eulithiotyphla, and that includes the moles and the shrews. Moles have these really big front feet, and that's used for digging and living underground. They also have these long pointed noses and very, very tiny eyes, and they use a very primitive form of echolocation to get around. Maryland is home to three species of moles. The most common is the eastern mole, which you will find in your backyards. One of the more uncommon moles, but also really cool moles, is this star-nose mole that has 22 finger-like appendages on its nose, and it's the fastest eating mammal in the world. Shrews are related to moles, and they have that long pointed nose and those tiny little eyes, but they don't have those giant front feet. They also spend much of their time underground. This is our largest shrew, the short-tailed shrew, which is actually a venomous mammal. It has a neurotoxin in its saliva, and you can commonly find it in your own backyard. Voles are often misidentified as moles and shrews, and they're actually rodents. And in the rodent family, rodents have these large front incisors, and they eat plants. The moles and the shrews are carnivores, and they eat meat, but the voles do not. So voles have very similar teeth to this beaver skull that I have right here. The voles also have larger eyes and more rounded faces, and they kind of look like a hamster. And you will find them in backyards, and sometimes they will eat your gardens. The next group are Canidae, which includes our canines, foxes and coyotes. Gray wolves are also part of this group, but gray wolves have been extirpated from Maryland. We have two species of fox in Maryland. We have the red fox and we have the gray fox. The red fox actually is not native to the state, and it traveled here on its own as humans changed the habitat and also removed predators, aka gray wolves and mountain lions, from the landscape. The gray fox is native, and it is one of the few members of the dog family that has semi-retractable claws that allows it to be able to climb trees. Now, these two species can look very similar out in the field. Obviously, the red fox has this gorgeous red color pattern. They also have a white tip on the end of their tail, and they have this black on the tips of their ears and also black stockings. So you can see them off in a distance by looking for those different color markings. The gray foxes, in contrast, have a more grizzled appearance, and they have a black tip on the end of their tail, and they do not have those dark legs or dark ears like you see with the red fox. This is going to be a species you're going to see in much more suburban areas and rural areas, whereas the red fox is highly adaptable and can be found in urban environments. The largest species of canine that we have left in Maryland is the coyote, and this is the eastern coyote here. It's about the size of a small German shepherd. It also has kind of a black tip on the end of its tail. It's highly secretive. And this species, much like the red fox, walked here on its own and showed up in 1972. We now have it confirmed in all counties in Maryland. It's considered to be a non-native species, so a species that isn't native to the region. All of these species are what we consider to be omnivores, with the coyote being the most carnivorous out of the three. Omnivores eat plants and meat as part of their diet, so you'll see those large pointed canines for eating meat, and then in the back you'll see some flatter molars that are designed for eating plant materials. The next group of mammals that I want to talk to you about are mustelids, and they're one of my favorite groups. Mustelids include our weasels and our river otters. They have these classically tubular-shaped bodies, long and skinny in appearance, and they're also top-level predators. This is one of our medium-sized mustelids. This is the common mink. It's dark brown in appearance and has this very distinct white chin patch. This species can be found in wetlands throughout most of the state except on the eastern shore. Our larger mustelid that we have here in Maryland is our river otter, and they can now be found across the state yet again. It has that tubular-shaped body, has a little bit of a lighter coloration on the underside here, and this is another top-level predator that can be found in wetlands. One of the best ways to view river otters out in the field is to actually look for piles of their poop, aka scat, or the special term for otter poop is called sprinked. The next group of mammals we're going to talk about are rodents in the order Rodentia, and specifically we're going to look at squirrels in the family Sciuridae. Our Delmarva fox squirrel is actually a rare squirrel that can be found here in Maryland on the eastern shore. It used to be federally listed. It's got this grayish white color in appearance and looks a lot like the more common gray squirrel, but the gray squirrel has much rustier coloration to its body, and it's significantly smaller than our big old Delmarva fox squirrel. In contrast, our regular fox squirrels are really rusty in color on the underside, and you can see that dark red tail compared to our Delmarva fox squirrel. And one of our largest species in the squirrel family here in Maryland is the groundhog, a very common backyard resident and a thing of folklore, especially in February on Groundhog Day. These are a large ground squirrel species, and interestingly enough, the underfur on groundhogs is dark black in color, and that helps it with absorbing sunlight, and these are species that are true hibernators here in Maryland. Other common Maryland rodents include beavers and muskrats. Both of these species are semi-aquatic rodents, and you can find them in these types of wetland habitats across the state. The beaver is our largest rodent that we have here in Maryland, and they have a glorious fur, which is basically a chestnut in color and very, very soft. And beavers were almost extirpated from Maryland due to overhunting for their fur. Essentially, they were made into products like hats, and it was a 200-year fashion statement to have beaver fur. When beavers were almost wiped out, an invasive species, the nutria, was accidentally introduced to Maryland. There were nutria fur farms over on the eastern shore trying to grow nutria for its fur, and it wasn't as nice as the beaver, so the nutria industry did not take off and the nutria were released into the wetlands. The problem with nutria in wetlands is that they eat the roots of wetland vegetation, causing the marsh to destabilize and wash away. And so we've lost thousands of acres of marsh on the eastern shore due to destruction by the nutria. Out of the three species, some of the things to look at for identification include not just the coloration of the pelts, but looking at the face. Beavers have dark whiskers on their face, so do muskrats. Muskrats are the smallest of the three species. In addition, those beavers have that flat paddle-like tail. Muskrat have a much more flattened tail that isn't as wide as the beavers. And nutria have this rounded tail that's furred. Another thing with nutria is they've got this long face with white whiskers, and that is a really good key character for identification, particularly when it's swimming in the water. So this species is considered to be an invasive species in Maryland. Invasive species are non-native species that cause problems. In contrast, the muskrat and the beaver are native to the state.